Hi Tapas.
Hi Aditya.
Hi Manoj.
Hello.
It's good to see the two of you together in one video.
Ah.
There are separate videos on Sudeep Audio's channel, but this is one of its kind.
बस अब साथ में काम किए तो साथ में दिखेंगे ही.
बिल्कुल. और इसी काम के बारे में बात करने मिले हम. We are talking about the movie and a journey in this movie called Lakshmi. You all have done a wonderful job, and we are here to understand how this whole process of music making, you know, because a lot of people just listen to the end result. कि क्या आया बाहर. एंड विद द फिल्म ऑब्वियसली द सॉन्ग्स एंड ऑल लुक बेटर, साउंड बेटर. सो हाउ डिड दिस एसोसिएशन तपस विद, आई मीन हैपन विद नागेश ऑन दिस फिल्म?
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक यू फॉर द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स फॉर द फिल्म. वी ऑल हैव एक्चुअली वर्क्ड रियली हार्ड ऑन इट. दिस इज माई थर्ड फिल्म विद नागेश. ही फर्स्ट अप्रोच्ड मी फॉर अ फिल्म कॉल्ड ये हौसला, विच इज येट अनरिलीज्ड. He heard my music of Hanuman and Return of Hanuman. At that time, he was directing for Percept, and he was called in the launch, and that's where he heard my music. He approached me and he said that one day we'll work together, I'd like to work with you. Worked on Ye Hausla, after that worked on Mode, and then consecutively Lakshmi. So that's how my association with Nagesh started way back in 2008.
Right.
And now,
and Manoj, how did you meet Tapas on this project?
I suddenly got a call from Tapas.
Okay.
Hi, this is Tapas. Always wanted to work with Tapas. Suna tha bahut.
ये मतलब एक स्टैंडर्ड लाइन है या सच में करना चाहते हो?
नहीं नहीं.
अरे बोलते थे मैं हमेशा बस
नहीं नहीं
बहुत सुना है.
नहीं नहीं I'll tell you.
जी.
सबसे पहले तपस से भी पहले नागेश कुकनूर ये जो बंदा है, जो डायरेक्टर है, इसके साथ काम करने की इच्छा थी. डोर, इकबाल, जब ये फिल्में हमने देखी थी तब से ऐसे लगता था कि यार क्या फिल्म मेकर है, इतना अच्छा. रॉकफोर्ट, जो भी जितनी उनकी फिल्में थी पहले जो बनाते थे, तो सपना था कि यार इस बंदे के साथ काम करेंगे, कुछ तो करेंगे जो भी अपॉर्चुनिटी मिले. एंड उनसे मिलना मुझे हुआ जब शंकर एहसान लॉय का 15 ईयर कंप्लीट हुआ था. तो एक पार्टी में मैं सामने से गया, मुझे कहा सर मैं बहुत बड़ा फ़ैन हूँ आपका, मैं लिखता हूँ, अगर आपको लगे कि मैं किसी स्क्रिप्ट में अगर काम आ सकता तो प्लीज़ लेट मी नो. उसके बाद मैंने अपने सारे गानों की CD बना के उनके यहाँ भेजी. बस उसके बाद मैसेजेस पे चलते थे, हैप्पी न्यू ईयर, मेरी क्रिसमस, सारे त्यौहार हम लोग SMS पे करते थे कि एक कॉल आ जाए. बट ऐसा नहीं हुआ.
पर कॉल तपस का आया.
कॉल तपस का आया. और तपस से, जैसे तपस के काम के बारे में सुनना, तो जैसे इन्होंने भी बताया जो बैकग्राउंड्स करते थे या जो भी, और जिंगल्स में इनका नाम मैंने सुना था. मैं भी ये कॉर्पोरेट और जिंगल्स करते रहता हूँ. तपस इज अ वेरी सुपर म्यूजिशियन सुपर. और एक कॉमन फ्रेंड है चिरंतन भट्ट, ही ऑलवेज यूज्ड टू टेल तपस एक लड़का है, सुपर म्यूजिशियन, वो कुछ हाड़ू करता है, यू हैव टू वर्क विद दैट गाय. और सब ये बातें चल रही थी और एक आध साल के ही अंदर हम लोगों का कॉल आ गया, बातें हुई, मिलना था, फर्स्ट मीटिंग हुई. और
एक्चुअली द क्रक्स ऑफ द स्टोरी इज दैट नागेश कॉल्ड मी फॉर द मूवी, आई रेड द स्क्रिप्ट एंड ऑल दैट. ही आस्क्ड मी के लिरिक्स के लिए क्या करें. सो आई सेड सर आई ऑलवेज वांटेड टू वर्क विद दिस गाय कॉल्ड मनोज यादव. Because I heard his work in Coke Studio and I think he's phenomenal for this project. We are looking for that folk fusion kind of वैसी lyrics, हमको rustic raw rural lyrics चाहिए, तो he's very good. So he said कि यार एक मनोज को मैं भी जानता हूँ. We both didn't know that we are talking about the same guy. And I said sir कहीं wrong number ना लग जाए, मैं एक काम करता हूँ, मेरे पास जो मनोज का number है मैं आपको forward करता हूँ, आप confirm करो कि वही है, फिर उसको phone करते हैं. So मैंने actually इसका number forward किया. Okay. And he said yeah it's the same guy, so that's when I called him.
Right.
So that's when he came onto the project.
And I'm so lucky to be a part of Lakshmi.
Correct. So let's come to that. Now, when you kind of were signed up for Lakshmi and you know, that formalities were over, the first thing that a director shows you or the writer shows you, I believe he's also the writer of the
yes,
film?
Yeah, yes.
Correct. So he met you and briefed you about the script?
Yeah, it was first me in the picture. I had read the script way back, and he gave me the script. I read the script, and that's when it sunk in that this is quite a serious movie. And then he would. After that, the lyricist comes in, because first I read the script and then we discuss who should write it. So that's when that story happened. That's when I introduced him to Manoj. We met. We had a few meetings and all of that.
But in those meetings, was Nagesh also present when all three of you met?
Yes, yes. The first
initially first two meetings me and Tapas did.
Okay.
इन्होंने मुझे समझाया कि ये
story है.
ऐसे पूरा detail में नहीं समझाया, but एक just कि हाँ ये है, ऐसा कुछ है. But I guess second or third meeting में Nagesh sir हमारे साथ में थे.
Yes.
And वो वहाँ से मतलब काम स्टार्ट हुआ कि
राइट तो इन मीटिंग्स में क्या बात होती है, मतलब स्क्रिप्ट तो पता है कि भाई ऐसी टाइप की ऊपर ऊपर से स्टोरी पता है, यू डोंट हैव द विजुअल्स विद यू, तो व्हाट आर द काइंड ऑफ डिस्कशंस दैट हैपन अमंगस्ट द थ्री ऑफ यू
म्यूजिकली और लिरिकली? लिरिकली मेरे लिए जैसे कि अगर आप एक स्क्रिप्ट सुनते हो और जहाँ एक सिचुएशन आता है कि सो हियर द सॉन्ग्स किक इन, अगर ये स्टेटमेंट आता है तो आपके दिमाग में एक अपना थॉट चल रहा होता है बिना डायरेक्टर से पूछे हुए ही. वो तो अभी आपको ब्रीफ दे रहे हैं ना कि ये कॉन्सेप्ट है, ऐसे ऐसे चल रही है स्टोरी, ये कैरेक्टर्स हैं, ये उनके कैरेक्टराइजेशन वगैरह सारे हम समझ में आ रहा होता है. तो आप अपने आप एक उस कैरेक्टर के लिए ना कुछ वर्ड्स बुनने शुरू कर देते माइंड में. मेरे साथ ऐसे होता है कि वो शुरू हो जाता है सुनते वक्त. तो जब सुनते सुनते हम लोग आते हैं तो एक पॉइंट पर आगे बोलते हैं यू हैव द सॉन्ग्स किक इन. अब लक्ष्मी में ये था कि आई मस्ट टेल यू इट इज़ वेरी इंटेंस फिल्म, ट्रू सच्ची फिल्म है, बहुत अच्छी फिल्म है. और सिचुएशंस इसमें ऐसे हैं ना कि सुनते वक्त बड़ी तकलीफ होती है जब उसमें आपको काम करना है और उस तकलीफ को जस्टिफाई करना है कि ये तकलीफ क्यों है, इसकी इंटेंसिटी क्या है और कितनी होनी चाहिए. बहुत डिफिकल्ट था बेसिकली. कोक स्टूडियो इज़ ओके कि वहाँ पर आपको एक अपना थॉट है, जो आपको एक गाना बना देना है वो देना, दैट इज़ अ सॉन्ग, बस एक सॉन्ग बनाना है. बट यहाँ पर वो चीज़ का जो थॉट वहाँ पर आना है म्यूजिकली, जैसे अभी अगर तपस कुछ कंपोज करना है कि मैं ये देख रहा हूँ, उसी मेलोडी में उसी यू नो उस मूड में आपको वो वर्ड्स ऐसे देने जो फिल्म के साथ बहे. So it was a very difficult task, but
it was difficult in a very different way. I'll tell you what. Since you asked about the initial meetings and what do we talk about, the first thing that I want to know about any film or any script that I'm working on is not the situations. Situations can be, they are very pretty self-explanatory in the script. I mean, if the song has to come here, it has to come there. But the more I talk with the director, the more I know what color of music is he looking for, what direction to take, because music has thousands of genres. Now what flavor is he looking for? It's not necessary that because the film is set in Andhra Pradesh and it's a rural setup, you have to do rural music. We can take a creative step forward and do something else. But that is what is the crux of any meeting for me, the initial meetings, where I want to know what sound is he looking for. So that's when I start asking him about references. What are the songs that come to your mind when you are writing the script? Because any director, when writes the script, he has certain things in mind. He has the cast, he has the actor, he has a lot of things in mind. So he would probably have music also in mind, that I want a Lambi Judai kind of a feel, I want Damadam Mast Kalandar kind of a feel, or anything he would.
So references are always given?
Always given. I always want references just to know where the director is going. So once that thing is locked, that's when we start talking about what do we want to now write about. Ab likhna kya hai? So,
but for me, references कभी work नहीं करते.
Okay. So now you have two different kind of minds.
No, I'll tell you what.
I have to write the situation. See, music.
No, references कैसे work करते हैं? References work in communication.
Yeah,
it's like, देखो, the director doesn't know the language of music, and I don't know the language of poetic writing. Let's just say that. I can't explain to him what kind of, for me, in any song, as far as the lyrics go, vocabulary is very important. It should fit the scheme of things. You can't just suddenly pull a word out of nowhere and put it in a song. It just sounds alien to me. So it's very important for me to tell him exactly what kind of a vocabulary I'm looking for. For that, I need references. Then I would give him examples of Namak Ishq Da, see the vocabulary package. Or I would tell him Kesariya Balam, that kind of a thing. Or I that's how I give him references for words and packages that I'm looking for, basically.
Correct. So, jab aap को ये रेफरेंस मिलता है कि मुझे थोड़ा डार्क काइंड ऑफ सॉन्ग चाहिए, उस टाइप के रेफरेंसेस देते होंगे तपस की, जैसे अभी कहा कि
नो, आई विल टेल यू व्हाट, लेट मी, आई एम सॉरी, आई एम इंटरप्टिंग यू देयर, दैट इज वेयर लक्ष्मी डिफर्स.
ओके,
द मूवी इज वेरी डार्क, द प्रीमाइस ऑफ द स्टोरी इज वेरी डिस्टर्बिंग एंड हार्ट ब्रेकिंग टू वॉच, बट वी कॉन्शियसली डिसाइडेड वी डोंट वांट सॉन्ग्स दैट हाईलाइट दैट. टेक फॉर एग्जांपल सुन सुगनारे. It comes at a time in the film which is the most painful scene of the film. All right, I'm not going to give you the details, obviously, of the scene, but Sun Sugnare, if you hear it just like that, without context of the film, without the context of the film, it comes across as a beautiful bidai song, where a father and mother are bidding the daughter goodbye as she gets married. It's a beautiful song, but the way it's put in the film, juxtaposition, is similarly Sunri Bauli, not a negative song at all. It's a song that gives you hope. A lot of hope.
The first song we worked was this Papam's.
सुनरी बावली.
उसमें हुआ ये था कि जो सिचुएशन जो जो स्क्रिप्ट के स्क्रिप्ट वाइज हम लोग देखते हैं वहाँ पर एक सैड सॉन्ग होना चाहिए था टेक्निकली. क्योंकि इस लड़की के ऊपर जो अत्याचार हो रहा है, जो जिस जिस चीज़ों से गुजर रही है वो इतना पेनफुल है, इतना दर्द है, और वो अपने आप को आज़ाद महसूस नहीं कर रही है वहाँ, और उसकी लाइफ और बुरे से बुरे उसमें गुजरती जा रही है,
दलदल में, कोई
दलदल में जैसे फंस गई, वैसे वो अंदर खींची जा रही है उसमें. तो वहां पर ये है कि वो अपनी सिचुएशन पे या तो रो सकती है या मतलब हेल्पलेस महसूस कर सकती है, ये उसका सिचुएशन है. बट वहां पर जो हमने सॉन्ग रखा वो आप अगर सॉन्ग सुनेंगे सुनरी बावली पापा उनका, तो उसमें आता है वो बात है जब आप फिल्म के साथ उसको देखते हैं. लेकिन क्या होता है, कोई भी बंदा कितना भी दुखी हो, बहुत हल्का बट छोटा 1% उसके अंदर एक होप तो होता ही होगा.
करेक्ट.
कि मैं यहाँ से एक दिन निकल जाऊंगा, मैं इससे बाहर आना चाहिए. भले वो 90% आपको दबा रहा हो बट कहीं ना कहीं अंदर आप फाइट कर रहे होते. Correct. तो हमने वो 90% का जो दर्द तकलीफ ये वो उसको साइड में हटा दिया, और वो जो बाकी का जो कुछ होप था उसको हमने इस गाने में लाने की कोशिश की. और इसमें मैं, नागेश सर और तपस, फर्स्ट मीटिंग में हम लोग क्लियर थे कि ऐसा कुछ पकड़ते हैं. एंड आई गेस वही एक पहला सॉन्ग था जिसमें कुछ करेक्शंस भी नहीं है. एंड आई गेस सारा लिरिक्स फर्स्ट गो में उस गाने में अप्रूव हुआ था.
एनी सॉन्ग इन अ फिल्म फर्स्ट इन अ फिल्म लाइक दिस वेयर इट्स नॉट लिप सिंक, वेयर इट्स नॉट लिप
सिंक, इट्स प्लेइंग इन द बैकग्राउंड.
या इट्स ऑल
वेयर इट्स प्लेइंग इन द बैकग्राउंड, वेयर इट्स देयर टू हाईलाइट अ सेंटीमेंट. इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फर्स्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर यू वांट अ सॉन्ग एज अ फर्स्ट पर्सन व्यू और अ थर्ड पर्सन व्यू. Do we want Lakshmi to sing this song for herself, or do we want someone else singing for Lakshmi? That is a huge difference.
Correct.
That's where the you know the song differs, because Sunri Bawli is a third person song. Sun Sugnare is a third person song. Only Aa Ghar Chale Hum is a first person song, and that we got Monali to sing because it's
she's
her playing.
Yeah.
She's correct. The character. Sunri Bawli, it's like someone telling Lakshmi that this is your life now. There is no escape, probably. So this is how you can make the best of it. That's right. What Sunri Bawli is all about. Sunri Bawli, tu apne liye khud hi mang le dua, koi tera na hona.
Tu apne liye jo karna hai, ab tu khud kar. Koi yahan par nahi aane wala hai. And kuch.
So these decisions are taken by who? Ki third person gaega, first person gaega.
Collective. It's a collective.
Acha, pehle se aapko khud pa nahi jata.
Nahi nahi, kuch
nahi. Because in such a situation, if you go first person, then you have to write it. Definitely. You have to write a sad song, which we didn't want to do.
Never.
And Nagesh, coming to that, Nagesh is always a man of, he is an incredibly musically oriented man. It's not a coincidence that all of his movies have great music.
Yeah.
He knows exactly what he wants. He reacts instantly. He understands what a scratch is. He understands what will happen when a new singer comes to sing it. Because initially it's all scratch lyrics and dummy lyrics and dummy voices and all of that. All of that happens. So it's hard for him not to get involved and give decisions, because that way he's a very creative man.
So. Correct. So speaking of singers, like you said, new singers coming in to sing. Who all, were selected, and how were they selected?
It was very simple. When I wrote Sunri Bawli, we sat down, me and Nagesh, to cast singers, and he said that I want Papon to sing the song. And I have always been a fan of Papon. I've heard some of his. I had heard some of, at that time I had heard some of his stuff. And Nagesh said that I met Papon in a party, and we instantly hit it off. I love the guy singing. And he said that he'd be interested in singing some songs for me. So I said, well and good. I mean, so it was, that was purely Nagesh's decision. Not that I didn't agree. So Nagesh called up Papon, and Papon agreed, yes, he'll do the song. And he came and he sang. Then...
During these recordings, is Manoj also present? Are you also present?
He has to be present.
बोलो अगर वर्ड्स चेंज करो लास्ट मिनट ऐसा होता है,
होता है, होता है, होता है.
सुनरी बावली का छोरी भी हो गया कल कोट के,
ऐसा भी हो सकता है. मतलब वहां पर कैसे हो, जब जैसे अभी
सी दैट इज ऑन द स्पॉट क्रिएटिविटी, दैट्स ऑन द स्पॉट. सी सडनली पैपॉन आया और एंड ही सिंगिंग, एंड लेट्स से ही कम्स अप विद अ व्यू पॉइंट, ए दिस इज रॉन्ग, और दिस इससे बेटर ये है, इससे बेटर ये है, इट्स इट्स
नहीं
यू
होता
कैन
कह
बी
रहे हैं,
रिजिड इन द
नहीं दैट
माइंड.
इज दैट, बट अक्सर ये भी होता है कि जब सिंगर गा रहा होता है, जैसे अभी तपस एक मेलेडी गा देता है,
या
बट
दिस इज
सिंगर
एन
आता है तो
पॉइंट.
इम्प्रोवाइज भी बहुत करता है, तो जब वो इम्प्रोवाइज करता है कहीं पे कुछ एक्स्ट्रा हरकतें जब गाते हैं, तो ऐसे लगता है कि वो छोटी छोटे वर्ड्स को खींचना अच्छा नहीं लग रहा है, फोर्स लग रहा है, या बड़ा वर्ड है वो उसमें वो हरकत फ्रीली नहीं ले पा रहे हैं, सो उसको हम लोग ऑप्शनल कोई वर्ड
तो
ढूंढते
ऐसा
हैं जहाँ पे या इट्स ऑल.
बट आप लोग ऐसा ऑब्जेक्शन लेके डेढ़ साना बन रहा अपना ये हरकत डाल रहे हैं अंदर
ऐसे, बट जब जहाँ अच्छे के लिए
डेढ़
साना बनना है फिर
सी देयर इज नो सेट रूल, देयर इज नो सेट रूल अबाउट दिस. एवरी कंपोजर अप्रोचेस हिज और हर सॉन्ग डिफरेंटली. देयर आर सर्टेन कंपोजर्स हु माइट बी रिजिड एंड हु वांट एग्जैक्टली हाउ दे हैव डन इट, देयर माइट बी सर्टेन कंपोजर्स हु गिव ऑल द फ्रीडम टू द सिंगर्स. सो
So in your case, you were...
In my case, it's very simple. Now see, my primary instrument is the keyboard. All right? I don't expect anybody to teach me how to play that. But I can't sing. I'm not a singer. I can sing basically. Just, you know, sing the melody out. That's why I call a singer, not for the voice, but because he's a trained singer. He knows how to take it from one note to the other, from one line to the other. Similarly, the flautist, only the flautist can know how a flute is played. I can't. Having said that, so when a singer comes to sing in the studio and he gives his own nuances, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't.
कभी कभी किसी को नहीं लगता होगा कि वर्ड चेंज करना चाहिए, लेकिन मैं ही बैठा हूँ मुझे लगता है यार ये वर्ड जब ये गा रहा अच्छा नहीं लग रहा है, तो मैं खुद रिक्वेस्ट करता हूँ सर कैन वी चेंज दिस वर्ड, मुझे लग रहा है इसका
करना पड़ता है ना कि
कलेक्टिव डिसीजन इन द स्टूडियो व्हिच इज वेरी हेल्दी.
उसका मुखड़ा कितना चेंज हुआ है मोनाली के सॉन्ग का,
बहुत
कम से कम उसके 5-6 ऑप्शंस
गाते गाते
गाते गाते
पहले
नहीं
भेजे,
गाते
हाँ, अच्छा
नहीं.
लग रहा है, देन फिर उसके बाद बहुत,
बट सी आई मीन
फोर्स लग रहा है.
ऑल आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज दैट इट्स नॉट समथिंग व्हिच इज वेरी अनकॉमन, इट्स अ वेरी कॉमन प्रैक्टिस, एंड वी डोंट चेंज द सॉन्ग कंप्लीटली इनसाइड आउट,
जस्ट वन और टू
वन वर्ड हियर वन वर्ड देयर, इट्स जस्ट विदाउट चेंजिंग द मीनिंग, अ बेटर फिट, अ बेटर यू नो
फोनेटिकली कुछ और अच्छा हो जाए बस, दैट्स इट.
राइट, सो माइनर.
हाँ हाँ माइनर बहुत,
लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये आंध्र प्रदेश में सेट है फिल्म.
हाँ.
तो देर आर टिपिकल वर्ड्स यूज इन आंध्रा, कायको ए वो, मतलब वो जो टिपिकल वहाँ के लोग बोलते हैं. व्हेन यू राइट द सॉन्ग्स फॉर सच अ फिल्म, यू नो द स्क्रिप्ट, यू रेड इट एक्सेट्रा, तपस हैज ब्रीफ्ड यू विद द फील व्हाटएवर, डू यू कॉन्शियसली पुट इन सच वर्ड्स सो दैट लगे कि अरे एसोसिएशन हो जाए उस जगह का?
बेसिकली क्या था
इसमें
लैंग्वेज लैंग्वेज
हिंदी थी, अनलेस एंड अंटिल द डायरेक्टर वांट्स समथिंग लाइक दैट,
बट लैंग्वेज हिंदी थी. अब जैसे हर बंदा हिंदी अलग बोलता है, जैसे मैं एकदम नॉर्थ का हूँ तो मेरी हिंदी बड़ी साफ होगी, बट एक जैसे महाराष्ट्र का कोई बंदा हिंदी बोलेगा जो इतना फेमिलियर नहीं है, तो उसकी हिंदी हिंदी होती है, बट उसका बोलने का तरीका अलग होता है. लेकिन अगर कैरेक्टर गा रहा होता तो डेफिनेटली हमें वो लैंग्वेज और वो वर्ड्स उस हिसाब से लिखने पड़ते हैं और गवाने भी पड़ते हैं शायद. बट सेंस जो आइडिया था तपस का, सर का और मेरा, कि हम लोग एक थर्ड पार्टी सॉन्ग रहते, एक बैकग्राउंड सॉन्ग है, सो इट कैन बी एनीथिंग, सो वो प्रॉपर हिंदी में हमने कर दिया, तो वो एक वहाँ पर फ्रीडम था उस चीज का.
व्हाट अबाउट अदर सिंगर्स, हाउ डिड, बिकॉज़ पैपॉन केम,
या थैंक यू, वी केम बैक टू दैट, वी आई थिंक वी डाइग्रेस्ड अ लॉट, या सो आफ्टर पैपॉन आई वाज आई वांटेड वी I was looking for singles for Sun Sugnare. I was very clear that I wanted two girls to sing it because I wanted to make it rustic, Shadi Ka Gana kind of a thing where two females are singing it. We considered a lot of so-called popular jodis, female singers, but they didn't work out. So then I was hunting for voices that are not actually jodis, but just pair them together.
How do you hunt? I mean, how do you look around for?
You...
Call friends,
you call friends, you go through your own
this
friend
list. This is also
list.
For the benefit
yeah,
of many who want work from in the industry.
Yeah, we
right?
start looking around. We start looking around. Maybe we call friends, maybe we look up on YouTube, maybe you consider some of the people you worked with or some of the people you've shortlisted kind of that you want to work with. So, I knew one singer that I always wanted to work with. I think she's very talented, Suchi Smita Das. And... she sang a few jingles and some ads for me previously, so I called her and I asked her, would you be interested? She said, of course. And I'm a composer who cannot confirm any singer till I've auditioned. I be very clear. I'm very clear when I call any singer that I need to audition you. You need to come and sing a few lines for me, or you know, one mukhra, one antra, and then
for this film or
yeah,
every
for film. Any film, for any film. I mean, I cannot call you and have you sing and just say, okay, you are final, because it needs to go through a filtration process. I need to sit with it. I need to sleep over it. I need Nagesh to hear it, or any director to hear it. We need to come at a collective. So she was okay with the whole idea of auditioning. She came, sweet girl. She sang the whole song for me. Now I'm looking for another singer, and I couldn't find anybody. I was looking for a rustic folk voice, a fat voice, and that's when Manoj told me that you should try this singer called Ankita Joshi. I said, okay, give me her number. And he gave me her number. But before calling her, I had to look her up on YouTube and see if she's done anything. And there was one song she was singing, and I really loved the voice. So I called her. She was very sweet. She also came. Both these singers, it's the first Bollywood song they sang. So she also came, she sang, and they just perfectly gelled in the song. So Nagesh has no issues about who sings the song as long as it's justified and it's done properly. So Nagesh fell in love with both the voices, and that's how Sunsugnare was casted. And coming to the last song, Aghar Jaleham, sorry, the third song, Aghar Jaleham, that's a first person view song in which the main protagonist Lakshmi is singing herself and exhibiting her own emotions. So it was very natural for us to give Monali a try first. Okay, since she's an incredible singer herself, let her try it. And I and Nagesh were very clear that we'll keep her only if she works for the song, alright? Just because she's the heroine of the film doesn't mean she's getting the song. So yeah. We both agreed on that. So we called Monali and we told her, see, you can sing, but only if you like it, we'll keep. So she's an incredible singer, very sweet singer. So she sang the song, and there was no reason for us to say, okay, no, we cannot use your voice. And it just went well. And lastly, the fourth song, Herehem, is a song which is basically, you can call it the promotional song. And so obviously we needed someone who was powerful enough and, you know, who has the crowd pulling capacity and all of that. So it's a Qawwali, obviously. So not many choices when it comes to Qawwali and Sufi. Obviously Kailash Kher is at the helm of Sufi right now, Bollywood Sufi at least. So we casted him. He was more than happy, he was more than glad. Now I'll give you an example in coming back to where we digressed. I'll give you an example of how lyrics change in the recording room. Kailash was singing, and there's this section in the Qawwali where it says, it's one of the most beautiful lines that I think anybody has ever written recently for a song like that. The song speaks about why are there atrocities on women in this country or in the world, and why are men the special children of God and not women. So to highlight that, he wrote one line that says, Radha hai yahi, Sita yahi hai, par kisi mein wo Ram aur Krishna kyun nahi hai. Alright, that's a very powerful emotion. Now when that line was being sung in the studio, Kailash just said, ke, kyun sirf Radha aur Sita? Har mazhab ko andar lo na.
That was his input.
Okay. That was his input. Har mazhab ko andar lo.
To isko lyrically fit karne mein.
We sat together.
Naam change karna tha.
So we from Radha and Sita, I was repeating it twice. Radha, Sita, Sita, Radha. Instead of that, we got Radha hai yahi, Sita hai yahi, Maryam hai yahi, Ela hai yahi. So, par kisi mein wo Ram, Krishna, that kind of a thing. So that was done
so
on the
works.
Spot.
Correct.
It's such a powerful emotion. He's got a valid point. Nobody thought about it. And it just worked. So it worked. As simple
true.
As that.
So the reason to digress was also to inform the audience that these things happen and it's not like a war.
No, of course not.
Because people outside don't know that these things happen.
Egos are involved and you know,
where teamwork, the sentiment of teamwork really stands out, why it's so important to not have your egos anyway, because the music suffers, the art suffers. I'll give you an example. I cannot compose without lyrics. Simple. Unless it's just a brainless dance number, EDM or something. I need lyrics to get through to a sentiment. So, and there are certain writers who cannot write without a melody. So I've gotten into this habit of writing dummy lyrics for myself. Alright? So when I can't present to my director with a na 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 la 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 la, I have to sing words to make sense of it. So I write dummy lyrics myself and compose them and then ask a writer to replace it. Now sometimes I also hit the ball out of the park and come up with some fantastic lines or some thoughts. Very rarely does that happen. So Sunri Bauli tu apne liye khud hi mang le dua, koi tera na hua, is what I've written actually. That was always part of the dummy. And Elahe and Nagesh and Manoj, they just agreed that this line is beautiful, but we don't need to change it. Now, if he had ego problems...
That is the song.
The song... तो वो दो लाइन रखी, बाकी का सब नया लिख दिया. Because we love the concept. के, okay, the thought is nice. Similarly, in Aa Ghar Chale Hum, I think Elahe was so hellbent on using what I had written. That's where, actually, that's the only song where a very cute clash happened between me, Manoj and Elahe. Because I said, no, I don't like what I've written. I mean, I'm not a writer. I think Manoj has come up with better line.
Mitra.
Yeah. I had written something which is inspired from here and there, just to give a concept and all of that. So, which I didn't like absolutely. But for some reason, Elahe and Nagesh loved it. So I said, okay, no, let Manoj write. That Mukhda got stuck so badly. I think he wrote 5 mukhdas, and because Elahe just wasn't convinced about the mukhda of that song, and so yeah, it happens sometimes. But it's so a cute clash. It's not like we are burning blood or we are out to kill each other or there are tempers flying and someone storming out of the room. No, it's right. not like that.
Like आपने 5 बार बोला कि mukhda लिखा और reject हुआ. मतलब ये वहीं का वहीं होता है या आप बोलते हैं मैं कल आता हूँ परसों आता हूँ.
Reject जैसा चीज नहीं था उसमें. हो ये रहा था कि ये अच्छा है लेकिन वो दिमाग में
मैं बोल रहा हूँ वहीं का वहीं होता है या बोल एक दो दिन का ब्रेक होता है.
ऐसा भी चल रहा होता है प्रोसेस.
आज एक घंटे में खत्म करो ऐसा
हमने नहीं.
कभी कभी ऐसे
जब डेडलाइन होती है देन यू हैव टू ऑल सिट टुगेदर एंड डू इट बट देन मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स एवरीबॉडी इज बिजी. आई कांट मैनेज टू बी हियर 24/7 सॉरी व्हाइल लक्ष्मी इज गोइंग ऑन. सो ही टेक्स अ ब्रीफ फ्रॉम मी, ही गोज अवे, मे बी ही विल सेंड मी वन लाइन ऑन व्हाट्सएप. He'll call and say, कि सर ये लाइन कैसी है, ये कैसा है, वो कैसा है, एंड देन आई एम फॉरवर्डिंग इट टू Elahe. हाउ इज दिस? Elahe will say, आई एम नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द मीटर, कैन यू सिंग? तो आई एम सिंगिंग इन व्हाट्सएप एंड सेंडिंग इट टू हर. ओह दिस साउंड्स गुड. सो इट्स लाइक दैट.
इट बिल्ड्स अप दिस वे. व्हाट अबाउट द रिकॉर्डिंग स्टूडियो, द इंजीनियर्स इन्वॉल्वड, द म्यूजिशियंस हू प्लेड, एनी ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर दैट यू यूज?
यू वांट टू पैन द कैमरा ओवर देयर टू शो द सॉफ्टवेयर
दैट यू यूज?
All composition and programming happens in this room. Some of the instruments also happen in this room. I love the sound that my room creates. But then, for example, the musicians that have played on Lakshmi are Parasnath has played the flute, Ankur Mukherjee has played the guitars and mandolins and ukuleles. Hiren Chate has played the tabla. Vivek Rajgopalan has played the ganjira. Yogesh More has played the Shehnai, Dilshad Khan Sarangi, a lot of live I've got in this. So certain instruments were dubbed here, certain instruments were dubbed in Ray and Raga, Akash Jetli, very good engineer, sweet engineer, and like the miking and the sound over there. Some of it is dubbed in Tanai Studio, Wow and Flutter. Singers were also dubbed in similar places. Finally it all comes back here in my logic. Everything is balanced. Correctly put. Not balanced. That's not my job. Everything, all the correct takes are selected, put into place, and then the whole thing is delivered to Farad, where he mixes in Sonic Laundry.
Right.
So that's how the musicians and
right. So how long is this whole process, right from your first meeting about the Lakshmi project till the final CD in your hand? How long did it take?
It was quite a long process. It was quite a long process. Not because we were creatively stuck or anything, but
It takes time.
And we take as much time as is given to us. It's if Nagesh had said, "Okay, boys, we only got 2 months, we'll finish it." But then if there's no fire, in Lakshmi, the release dates were being pushed down because of the censor issues and everything. So we started having more and more time. So I'm telling Farad, okay, relax, we have time. Take it easy. Because sometimes an engineer or mostly the mixing engineer, Farad, would call me and he would say, dude, I can't do this in 2 days. I've got that session coming in between. And I'm like, okay, do that session. We have time. So we can do it like that.
And I must admit that for the first time in watching so many movies in my life, I saw credits of musicians and engineers and recording studio names and singers, etc., come prominently in the end credit roll that came. I mean, it was very prominent.
I think every movie has it. I don't know what you mean by prominently.
It was very visible. It ended with that. Yeah. And the song playing in the background. Yes. I mean, that's what I'm...
I think that's because I'm OCD. I have this habit of making sure every name goes through to the production department and make sure when the credits are happening. So I make sure... In fact, I remember Suchismita Das. It's a very funny story. I mean, how would you know if a person decides to change her name, right? So I had sent away all the credits to Ranjit, who was the AD on this, and he was handling the post also. I sent it to him, these are the credits, and I want them exactly like this in the credits and CDs and whatever online credit details. No spelling mistakes, make sure all of that is done. After that's delivered, 3 days later, so I'm just casually speaking to Suchi on the phone, and I said that, okay, your name is gone, and okay, now you can take it as confirm you're singing the song, because we always joke about till it's released, yeah, it's not your song. So we were joking about, hey, what name did you give? I said, Suchi Smita Das. No, I've changed it to Suchi only. I said, now you tell me. So then I said, okay, hang on, let me speak to them. I called up Ranjit and I said, please change the name if you haven't. Okay, sir, it'll be done. On a serious note, since you mentioned this, I can't stress the importance of credits. At the end of the day, it's not the check that gives you the satisfaction. It's seeing yourself that gives you satisfaction. It's reading that name in the opening titles or reading it in the end scroll. That is what makes everything worth it. That is what we work for. We don't work for the money. I mean, checks never gave you that appreciation or that satisfaction. It's important, but it doesn't give you that satisfaction. I'm just comparing the satisfaction you get when you see yourself or
read your name. That's what I meant when I saw the names coming up in bold and big fonts, and I even clearly remember the last name was Faraz. Yeah. So it's that, you know, it usually ends with some Dolby and Kodak and this and that, but here it was. I mean, so it is a good thing that even the director is giving value to you guys, and he realizes the importance of music to a film. So once again, it was a truly outstanding film.
Thank you.
And music is also good. I really am asking people who are watching this video to go buy the DVD, or I'm sure it will come on TV soon.
Yeah.
But it's a hard-hitting film, but one cannot run away from not watching it by, you know, saying that it's very... रोज देखते हैं मालूम है देखोगे नहीं तब तक मालूम नहीं पड़ेगा
ये सच्चाई है जिसे आप पीठ कितना भी घुमाओ एक बार सामने आके खड़ी हो जाएगी
सो व्हाट्स द कंफर्ट लेवल सिंस इट्स आई बिलीव दिस इज द फर्स्ट प्रोजेक्ट यू गाइस हैव वर्कड ऑन
या द टू ऑफ अस
करेक्ट सो व्हाट्स योर कंफर्ट लेवल आफ्टर यू वर्क विद ईच अदर ऑन अ प्रोजेक्ट
हाउ इज मेरा तो अब ऐसा है कि पहले मैं बोलता था मुझे 3-4 दिन का टाइम दो अब मुझे लगता है 3-4 घंटे में मैं तपस के लिए लिख सकता हूं इतना कंफर्टेबल
बहुत ही वी डिड अ फ्यू जॉब्स फॉर few title songs for some serials and all that so
correct
I think the comfort level is beyond
shuru mein thoda sa hesitation hota hoga and
nahi pehle ye tha ki jaise mere mujhe likhne ke liye bahut shabd hain main ye likhun tapas ko pasand aayega ki nahi wo usko acha lagega the us hesitation mein main ye sochta hu usko kya pasand aayega waise words likhu but ye first ek do song ke liye hota hai but first meeting mein isne comfortable kiya sir mujhe likhna nahi aata
No, but having said that,
you have to do that.
I'm sure there are a few composers who can't really comment on lyrics, or probably you don't even care about what's written as long as it's written in meter. I'm just saying there are all kinds of people. I'm sure there are composers like that.
Phonetically, they want ki acha lage bas itna.
I think I understand lyrics. I think I understand poetry.
Which is important for.
I don't know if it's important. It's just a habit. It's just a habit. Poetry interests me. I like to comment on something. I have an opinion about lyrics. Let's just say that I have my own tastes. Very strong tastes. I can be very averse to certain words, or I can fall in love with certain words. So yes, that's why probably he gets that feeling from me, because I react to everything he writes. It's not like ठीक है मैं director को दे देता हूँ. If he says okay, then I am okay. It won't go to the director till I okay it. It's as simple as that. In certain situations.
Right.
And पहले start में था, but पहला ही song हम लोगों का बिल्कुल इसमें correction
था. Icebreaker जैसा जो हो गया.
It was smooth and
super.
और कभी-कभी तपस अगर director को line नहीं अच्छी लगी, तो वो stand रखता है कि नहीं, I like this line. क्यों नहीं रखना उसका एक reason बता दो, उसके बाद change करते हैं. So that way जो उसने बोला कि he understands poetry and तो पूरे गाने में अगर एक line किसी को नहीं पसंद है और इसको पसंद है, तो वो He has reasons कि क्यों पसंद आ रही है और आपको क्यों नहीं अलाइन चाहिए वो हमें समझाओ सो दैट वे बट एंड इट्स वेरी गुड फन
कंफर्ट लेवल द कंफर्ट लेवल इज टू इजीली एक्सप्लेन टू यू हाउ डू यू डिफाइन कंफर्ट लेवल इज वेरी सिंपल व्हेन आई से व्हाट आई वांट टू से इन द फ्यूएस्ट ऑफ द वर्ड्स पॉसिबल टू हिम नाउ आई नो कि मैं ऐसा बोलूंगा तो मनोज विल गेट इट he knows my taste and he knows the way the language
exactly.
I speak. Bas, that is comfortable.
That's comfort.
And he also knows, okay, if I write this, he's not going to like it. Or if I write this, he'll love it. That's comfort level. Predicting somebody's reaction is comfort level.
And that's happening.
Yeah.
Superb. And once again, thank you Tapas and Manoj for coming
thank
on
you,
the channel.
Thank you so much, Aditya.
And we look forward to doing more videos with you with other films
yes.
also in the times to come.
Yeah, sure, definitely.
Yeah? Thanks again.
Thank you.